Today it's about the most mysterious planets, Rahu and Ketu. Actually, they are not planets, but the sensitive points of the zodiac called nodes. Rahu is north node and Ketu is south node. The nodes are the two meeting points where the orbit of the moon intersects the earth's path around the sun. I'll be talking about the significations of Rahu and Ketu and what can be expected when Rahu is in Aries and Ketu is in Libra, and how best we can handle this placement. This is going to be a major change of planets in March 2022 to September 2023 for Rahu Ketu. Lastly, I will also mention briefly about how it is like when Rahu Ketu are in Aries, Libra, Navamsa. As right now in transit, Rahu Ketu are in Aries and Libra, Navamsa till 6th of October. Talking about the significance of the nodes, Rahu Ketu, they are one, but just got separated in two parts, but they both work together as a team with their individual role as per the sign and the house placement. Impact of Rahu will have mention of Ketu, and the same for Ketu. We cannot just talk about Ketu or its independent impact without mentioning Rahu. They are correlated and infuses each other's impact. Rahu is our future, the destination where we have to reach, our purpose, and each moment we are heading towards that. It's all about expansion, challenges, and the unknown, as Rahu is famous for getting into the unknown. Ketu is the past, the driving force behind everything, the powerhouse from where we have come, our tools in terms of skills that we have and we carried with us. It is all about using those skills, the tools, to reach the destination, the purpose of our life. When Rahu is in Aries, then it adapts all the significance of Aries. Like, it's all about the self, your own needs, goals, ambitions, your desires, name, fame, your health, your character. And when Ketu is in Libra, it's all about including others in your life, your close relationships, partnerships, others' dream, whoever is in your life, their goals, their needs, their ambitions, and everything about them, their aspirations. So when the purpose with Rahu in Aries is to gain independence, then the tool through which we can gain that is our close relationship. And that is Ketu in Libra. You cannot achieve independence without having proper understanding of your relationship with others and the rest of the world. Aries Libra is 1/7 axis of the natural zodiac. It indicates our natural relationships with others and involves the two opposite signs and houses. Aries opposes Libra, and both the sign Aries and Libra are odd male signs and movable signs. Rahu will fight for his freedom and Ketu will try to cut off the bonding. The only goal Rahu has is to have independence, individuality. He proves his individuality with his freedom, and Ketu helps it to achieve that by separating you from the world. But is that the purpose of Rahu Ketu? Certainly no. The goal here is to bring balance in both the significance, harmonizing our needs with those of our partner or whatever is in front of us. And that will bring this axis into the balance. Aries is movable, odd, and fire sign. Libra is also movable lord and air sign. Mars and Venus are the natural rulers of these two signs, and they are neutral to each other. So there is no strong opposition. If they know they, with Rahu Ketu, there is no buts and ifs. They are determined to give results. We just have to figure out what way and how it will manifest and how best we can handle it. This Aries Libra axis has friendly elements, fire and air. They both are compatible to each other and they enhance each other's quality and they work in coordinations. The Lords, the Mars and Venus are neutral towards each other. But if we look as a basic nature of Mars and Venus, then there is vast difference between the two. Mars is like masculine force in us and Venus brings femininity within us. So the discord and the conflict in relations is very obvious. As Mars has aggression, Aries will support individuality. So Rahu will try to achieve dominance and control on the circumstances somehow. Whereas Libra is all about opportunities, maintaining balance, do justice. And Lord Venus is all about keeping peace and nourishing any relationship. Both have clear aim. There is apparent conflict, but they will achieve balance ultimately. After the conflict, maybe. As the dominance of Mars will get subdued by practicality of Venus. Venus won't mind surrendering like Ketu. If this transit is working good for you, then you will think and behave independently. But you will also consider your partner's viewpoint and the way your decisions will impact others in general. This is the sign of a good balance of this axis. But if the transit is making you ruthless about others, their needs and their viewpoints, then this placement will make things little difficult for you to achieve your goals. But ultimately you will learn hard way to balance these interpersonal relations between self and others, you versus rest of the world. As both are important and balance is the key here to any success. Any extremity will destabilize you. Everything in nature exists in opposite pairs or dualities. Male, female, day, night, positive, negative. Though they are opposite in nature, but still they show harmony and balance on the earth. Nature has perfect balance. All the elements in the nature are in proper proportion. We get best vastu with nature. So it's always good to follow the principles of nature, be with nature and have right thoughts, good health. In our chart also, signs in opposite position are the same nature or gender. They are complementary to each other. The opposite houses apparently look opposite in their approach, but actually they are complementary to each other to reach any target. They help each other. It's like push and pull effect. You cannot move forward unless you give what the other person or the opposite is asking from you. It's like the toll that you have to pay to go forward in your life. See, they are opposite, so naturally there will be conflict, challenges. But with elemental compatibility, they will work to achieve balance. And that's the only way to have stability. With Aries Rahu and Libra Ketu, the struggle is between your freedom and your dependency on the others. You need to take care of your own liberty and also actively consider others need and the role they play in your life. The determination and the stubbornness of Rahu should be used to do everything to achieve this balance. And the spirituality of Ketu will help you do that by letting go, by sacrificing whatever is needed. Also, too much of dependency on others will bring conflict in relations. So, having individuality in the right proportion will ease things out and bring balance. Doing your share of things and responsibility is like bliss to the other person. And the aim should be to do anything to maintain the peace by doing what's needed. But still, stand up for yourself every time by initiating to resolve the toughest matter. That's the theme of this Aries, Rahu and Libra Ketu. Currently, Rahu Ketu changed their Navamsa to Aries Libra. Earlier, they were Vargottama in Taurus and Scorpio. Navamsa are the results of the planets and can be interpreted as an independent chart. We shall know the strength of the planets and how internally they will manifest. Every 2 months, the Navamsa changes for Rahu and Ketu, and the role they play also changes, more so internally. To see how Navamsa results, we need to check the original placement of Rahu Ketu, and from there, where this Rahu and Ketu in Navamsa are. In the current scenario, Rahu is in Taurus and Ketu is in Scorpio, with their Lord as Venus and Mars respectively. But it is reverse in Navamsa, as Rahu is in Mars's sign Aries and Ketu in Venus's sign Libra. The role is interchanged. So the same agenda of Rahu Ketu is taken forward with different roles, interchanged roles. There is elemental compatibility with this opposite signs. This is the biggest reason or the possibility that things would work out. The goals can be achieved and there can be completion of the target. There is no stubbornness of the fixed approach, as now the signs are movable and not fixed like Taurus and Scorpio. There is flexibility which will help you go forward, and the significance of Aries and Libra will help to achieve the goals. You may have to struggle. There will be challenges, but the movable nature of the signs will help you to go through that in a speedy way. In March 2022, Rahu and Ketu will change their axis in transit to Aries and Libra. Expect some similarity in the results for those 18 months, the way you are feeling now in this coming 2 months till 6th of October. This will be the glimpse of that transit, not completely, but yes, apparently. Of course, the house that they are in, the aspect, if any, the lordship, the dasha period, all this will certainly matter to come to any concrete conclusion. But yes, similar kind of struggle and feeling, the theme would be the same. There will be confidence and determination to achieve your goals. Just maintain balance with interpersonal relations and rest will follow. With that, I will end this session. I wish you all a balanced time. Thank you for your time and check out this channel for more such updates. Bye for now. Thank you.